Databutton's new MCP tool allows you to build custom tools for your AI assistant like Claude, Cursor, or any other assistant that integrates MCP. You may have heard of APIs before, which allow applications to communicate with each other. MCPs are like APIs, but they allow AI assistants to connect with external services and bring that data and functionality into the AI assistant's capabilities. Databutton has made it really easy to build MCPs in your browser, host them on Databutton, and connect them with AI assistants like Claude. In this video, we're going to build an MCP in Databutton that connects to a stock API, which gives us live stock data in our AI assistant, Claude Chat. Databutton makes this really easy to build on the web, and host it all on Databutton. To supplement what you're going to learn in this video, click the link in the description and go to the page I'm on right now, which is going to give you even more information about how to use Databutton MCP, templates, example use cases, and more. Thank you so much to Databutton for sponsoring this video. Let's get into it. So we're going to go ahead and click New App. And what we're going to type is, it doesn't matter as much because we're not going to build out a full app in this tutorial. We're just going to build out the API that we're going to tap into. But we can say a stock data app. And let's continue. We'll say using the FinHub stock API. So I'll show you how to connect to that. And we're going to click continue. And we'll just skip the next two sections. And then we're going to continue without integrations as well for this specific use case. And we're just going to let the app be created. So the MCP is going to connect to our API that we create here. Of course, you could build out a fully functioning app and then still have the MCP connect to the API. But again, for this specific example, we're going to build out just a basic API in the backend. And then we're going to connect that to our Claude chat through MCP. So here, again, it gave us our plan for like the full setup. But what I'm going to do is instead of doing one of these plans, I'm just going to go over here and say, build an API in the backend for the FinHub stock API to enter a stock ticker and get stock information. And then go to FinHub. So I'll go and show you how to do this. So here in FinHub, just go ahead and get a free API key. So just create a free account. So we'll create an account, which will give us an API key. And then I'm going to go up to the top left to documentation. And just in case Databutton doesn't have this information, I'm going to just give it some of this information. So I'm going to copy from the top down to authentication and down to rate limits. I'm going to copy that, go back into Databutton, and I'm going to say here is documentation for the API. And then I'm going to scroll down. So what this is doing is basically giving our Databutton app, the AI, information about how to connect to this API, the FinHub, which is then going to connect to Claude. So it'll all work together shortly. And then I'm going to go to company profile 2, and then I'm going to say, I'm going to give it example code. So let me go to curl, or I'll go to, it shouldn't matter actually. So we'll go to curl, and then I'm going to copy this. Go back to Databutton and say, here is an example API call and paste that in, scroll down. And then we'll go back to the documentation and I'll say, here is an example response. And we'll go back to Databutton. I'll say, here is an example response. Okay, awesome. And then I'll say one more thing. I'll say, I can provide an API key. So I'm going to copy everything, but then click. I'm wondering if it's going to let me do it without. Okay, I think it's going to make me basically create a task here because this is like a new task that I'm giving it. So I'm going to say set up API for FinHub. And then I'm going to say create and start task. So there we go. So now this is like a new task that I just gave it a plan for. And now it's going to start building it out. And what's nice about Databutton is it basically researches. It might also even be researching the API documentation in the backend. So it's possible I didn't even need to give it any of that documentation. But either way, it can't hurt. And now it's going to look for more specific endpoints about the key endpoints. So I think it is doing research and searching the web in the backend anyway. But I'm going to pause the video and then I'll let you know once there's something we can act on. Okay, so now it says it understands how to use it and it's asking me for the API key. So let's go back to our account. Just go ahead and copy the API key. Again, it's free. We can use it on the free tier. I'm going to paste that in and click send. And now it's going to keep working, installing the packages. So I'll pause the video while it's working and building it out. Okay, so it says it's finished. I'm going to click mark as done. And then if we go to the preview tab up here under APIs, we can see there is now a FinHub API setup. And while it doesn't currently have a front end for us to test it out, technically we could go ahead and just build the integration to Claude right now via MCP. But what I'm going to do is, let's say yes, it's asking if we want to do the front end. So I'm going to say yes, please build a simple front end so a user can interact with the API. So I'll just select the task, create a new one, create front end. So I want this to be as simple as possible. And then we can just test it out on the front end before we actually set up MCP to use it within Claude itself. Okay, so this is what it created. It actually built a lot more than I expected, but it's actually pretty cool. It built out like a full stock app, basically. It even's pulling in news through the news API that is available through this service that we're using, FinHub. So this is what it built. We can search for stock. So let's say we search for Google. It'll show search results. We can click on it. And we can see it's pulling in actual data, the market cap, etc. So pretty cool that it's all working correctly. So what this tells me is that the actual app here is working. So the API is working. It's getting in real data. So that means when we connect it to our MCP, we should be able to get all of this data directly through Claude. So let's go to settings and let's go to production. And what we need to do is click enable MCP. So I'm just going to do that. It takes maybe a minute or two to generate. And the thing to keep in mind with this tutorial is this is just one example of one kind of API data point that we're able to bring in here through Databutton. But in theory, you could build out anything through Databutton and then connect it to Claude. So again, I'll let this generate and then I'll come back once we have this API, or not API key, but is API key for connecting to the MCP server. All right, so here we have our key. What I'm going to do is, well, before we do anything else, what you need to do is make sure you have Claude Desktop downloaded onto your computer. So this is the desktop version of Claude. This will not work in the web version. It only has to be in the desktop version. So go ahead and download that. And then once we do, we will jump back to Databutton. So back in Databutton, if we click this button, learn more about building your own MCP in Databutton. If we scroll down, so we already enabled it. We built a tool. And now we need to connect it to Claude Desktop. So what we need to do is go to the Claude Desktop app. So here it is. We're going to go up to the top, go to the settings. So this is like from the top settings, not your profile settings. So once you have the settings up, we're going to go to developer. We're going to click edit config. And when you click edit config, it's going to open up the file on your computer. And you're just going to double click on the file. And that file is essentially here. You need a file editor on your computer to open this up. And this is basically where we're going to add in the configuration for Databutton here for the MCP. So I was playing around with the Zapier MCP, which I just deleted. But let's go back to Databutton real quick. And here we can see this is the example configuration. So I'm going to copy that. We're going to go back to our file, which is right here. Paste that in. Now we can go back to Databutton. We're going to go to our key and copy it. And then we'll go ahead and paste our key right here. And then make sure you hit save. So we save that file. So that's just a file on your computer that Claude Desktop has access to. Then one thing you're going to want to probably do, I had this issue, is open up your terminal on your computer or on your Mac. If you have a Mac, you could just go search for terminal and open it up. And do the command brew install UV and then hit enter. I already did this, so I don't have to do it again. But this was one thing I had to do to make the MCP server work correctly. And once you have that, we're going to go back to Claude. And then we just need to restart it. So go to the top. And we're going to quit. So make sure you just quit out of Claude. And then there's actually one more thing I forgot to do. We have to deploy our app. So the app has to be deployed for the MCP to actually work. So we'll just let it deploy real quick. I'll pause the video while it does that. All right. So now that our app is deployed, we're going to go back to Claude. I want to make sure we close it out. So quit Claude, and then we'll open it back up. Okay, awesome. So now that we open it back up, if everything is successful, we're going to see these MCP tools available. So I'm going to click here and we can see we have a bunch of different tools available. Search symbol, get symbol news, get stock quote, get market news, get company profiles. So we have all of these basically abilities that are coming directly from our app. So these are all the abilities that were in our app itself. So now we'll try to use it. So let's say, give me the stock price and the latest news about the Meta stock. And let's hit enter. And then what Claude is going to do is it is essentially knows the tool abilities, the MCP abilities that it has available. So we're going to click allow for this chat. And we're going to click allow for this chat again. And then here we go. So it's giving us the information that it got directly from our MCP. So it has the current stock price, the change, the range, open, close, and then latest news about Apple directly. Sorry, about Meta directly. So let's try one more follow-up question. Let's say I want to know the market cap. So say, what is Meta's market cap? And I click allow again. And there we go. It's giving us the exact market cap of Meta. I'm checking on another screen, and that is correct. Let's try something a little bit more interesting. So let's say, can you give me the stock price of Meta and its 10 closest competitors? Maybe five close competitors. Meta, stock price, and market cap. Competitors, please put it in a table. So this is just like a little bit more of a, you know, complicated ask. So here it looks like it's searched using Claude search to get Meta's top competitors. And now it's going to go through these competitors and get that information that I asked for. So hopefully it's able to do all of that. It looks like it's doing Snapchat now. And it's getting TikTok. Well, TikTok's not a public company, so curious what it'll... Okay, so it's finding non-public companies. It's interesting because it used the search function. But let's see what it ends up doing. Okay, interesting. So this is what it did. It got Meta, Alphabet, Pinterest, Snap. The other one's TikTok, not a public company. And then X, stock symbol is US Steel. So not actually a competitor, but it did let us know that, which is helpful. And then here it's telling us these are privately held as well, which is cool. But overall, pretty cool. I mean, that worked. We could give it a list of stocks. We could do all sorts of things and just pull this data. And now I have essentially live stock data available in my Claude app. So I hope that you found this helpful. Thank you to Databutton for sponsoring this video. Check the link in the description to go to Databutton to build your own MCP and connect it to Claude. You can also connect this to Cursor or Windsurf or something like that. But I find it really helpful to use in Claude desktop app. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free content like this. Leave a comment below if you have any questions at all, or if there's anything you want us to talk about in the future. And also check out No Code MBA if you want to learn more about building with AI and no code tools. That's nocode.mba, and you'll be able to go from start to finish learning from experts across various no code and AI tools, including Bubble, Webflow, Airtable, Zapier, and much more. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.